We called it out 5 years ago, and we're expanding on it today, and we'll be expanding on it for years to come. When we see a successful business in one part of the city, you know what I like to say? Let's invest in them. And let's see them in another part of the city, like Ward 8, that needs good food. We created a fund those 5 years ago called the Neighborhood Prosperity Fund. And it was that fund that allowed us to make the first grant of $800,000 as a seed. And you know what happens to seeds. If you keep feed them, they will grow. And they will blossom into a positive enhancement in a community. And that's exactly what we see here today. We're making even better. You're going to get in this market and you're going to see, I don't care if you live in Ward 1, Ward 8, Ward 4, Ward 5, you want good food. You need nutritious food. And we know that nutritious food is just how we get started to a healthy life. What we've seen for sure in the last 24 months is we need to do everything possible to make sure our communities have healthy lifestyles, food options, food access. And we've been deprived for too long. This is an investment. This week we made a further investment. Did you hear about it? $9 million from the Food Access Fund that will allow 8 local restaurants, remember the model, remember, successful in one part of the city can be successful in another part of the city, like right here in Ward 8. So DC-based places like the MLK Deli and Half Smoke will open new locations in Ward 7 and 8. And those grants are just $9 million of the $58 million fund. So we will be opening applications for the Nourish DC Fund again, so more locations can look right here to Ward 8 to open their businesses. We know that sometimes the government has to be first. This is what we went down to the council to tell them about St. Elizabeth's. Because at St. Elizabeth's, just 7 short years ago, the project hadn't kicked off. Nothing was happening. We didn't have an anchor. We just had promises. So we went in there. Some people are criticizing it today. They are. But we went in there with $58 million to build the entertainment and sports arena right here in Ward 8. And that was a seed that is starting to grow. Because now not only do we have the entertainment and sports arena, we have new housing for new Ward 8 residents that they can buy and that people can afford. We're also going to have a brand new state-of-the-art transformative center for our men who are experiencing homelessness so they can get a fresh start. And in a couple of short years, we're gonna have, just like we promised, a brand new state-of-the-art hospital right here in Ward 8. That's what we're gonna have. And that's, you know, as your council member like to say, that's the vision, and without vision, the people will perish. That's the vision. Let's do something, Trey. Let's do something, because that is the vision. And it is becoming a reality. And that's what you can do with longevity.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You can do it.